Hi friends, today I will show you how to rebuild a CPU. When the CPU overheats, all motherboard is dropped, causing 30 CPU joints. You need to rebuild the CPU. This is a 2015 Intel 5th Gen CPU. This is a 2013 or 2014 Intel 1st Gen CPU. Both are from 13-inch MacBook Air motherboards. Now, we demonstrate rebuilding a 5th-gen CPU. On the CPU, there are two silicon crystals. Small one is the PCH. Long one is the CPU. Because this CPU is just taken from the motherboard, we must remove residual high-temperature tin, applied flux to the CPU. Use soldering iron to scrub high-temperature tin off the CPU. Be gentle, avoid damaging the pads. After scrubbing, weak to even the CPU's pads. Make sure that each pad is flat. Make sure the chip has cooled down. You can touch the chip's silicon with your hands. No burning means it is cold. Use plate washer water to clean flux off the chip. Make sure each solder pad is clean. Now the chip's pads are clean. Put a thing layer of flux to the chip, not too much. If too much, when blowing with the whole air gun, so the burrs will jump out. After applying flux, take out the DS90A. The case includes CPU, GPU, PCH, SMC, CD3215, various types of RAM and VRAM, touchpad and other small BJ chip sensor for Apple motherboards. Find the correct sensor for the CPU. This is jig. This is the magnetic base. Next, we start rebuilding. Okay, repair the base. Insert the CPU. Sensor is 4th and 5th gen CPUs. So the board size is 0.45. Okay, 0.445. Align one corner of the sensor to the CPU on the station. The magnets automatically attract the sensor. Align solder pads to the each hole. Take out 0.45 solder bolts. Open the lid. Pour the bolts onto the station. You can pour a little more, but do not exceed the position of the station. Gently shake the station. Make sure solder bolts reach CPU solder pads. Pour excess solder bolts back into the bottle. You can use paper towels to assist. Make sure no solder bolts are left on the station. Okay, you must sure no solder bolts are left on the station. Now, every solder pad has solder bolts perfect. Set whole air gun temperature to 315 degrees Celsius, wind speed to 5. Press the sensor down with tweezers because this types of chips have lots of capacitor underneath. We must press down with tweezers, then the sensor with no budget out. First, preheat the chip with the whole air gun. Blow around the chip. After the chip is evenly heated, start to heat the solder board from the left. When solder boards sink and become shiny, they have melted. 2 minutes to heat the entire chip. Don't worry about damaging the chip from blowing. Using this station, the damage is small. The best maintenance dissipates heat well, so the chip will no damage easily from blowing. Good. First round of heating is complete. Let the chip cool a little. Add a little flux to the chip. Make sure every hole has flux. Okay, little is okay. Second time, heating the chip. Its purpose is to let every solder board wear better on the solder pad. Heat around 1 minute. Okay, now every solder board is welded perfectly onto the pad. After the chip cools slightly, remove the jig. You cannot wait until the chip is completely cold, because if the chip is completely cold, flux sticks to the chip and is difficult to remove. Use tweezers to remove the stencil. Separate chip from stencil. Each solder board on the chip is soldered in place. CPU rebooting is done. Thank you. See you next time. Bye bye. Goodbye.